So I was recently asked if it was possible to save a voicemail on your iPhone. And I thought, well, it's got to be because that would be incredibly useful. And it turns out it is. It's very useful and easy to do. So let me go into my phone app here. And I'm going to switch to voicemail by tapping voicemail at the bottom right. And there I have a voicemail message I've recorded. If I tap on that, I can see the message. I have the play button at the bottom. I also have a transcript, which is something new that Apple's experimenting with, which is very useful. And I have a share button. At the upper right, there is a little box with an up arrow. And I can tap that and I get a variety of ways to share this message, which is really cool. So I can send it over a text message. I can send it via email. I can add it to notes, do all these different things. Even at the bottom, I have the ability to just send it to my iCloud Drive. What happens in almost all these cases is the voicemail is converted to a standard audio file format and exported as a file, which I can then use. So this could be really handy. Like, for instance, if somebody were to record something for you and you want to use it in something you're creating, an iMovie or GarageBand, if it's a meaningful message you want to save, if it's a important message like maybe directions or information that you might need and you want to kind of save it and archive it while keeping your list of voicemail clean inside your iPhone. All sorts of interesting ways to do this. So let's take a look at testing this out. So an easy way to do this might be to do the add to notes, and you can see I can choose note, I can hit new note here, and it's exported as an M4A, so I can now play it there inside of the notes app. If I go back to the message there, let's share it again. Let's do iCloud Drive. That's a really just good way to just get it onto your Mac. I'm going to put it in a folder here that I've called MacMostTemp. And now if I look on my Mac, I can see that I've got that file sitting there in that folder. It looks like any app that can handle audio input is included here in this list, just as any standard share sheet there. You can even use AirDrop there just to kind of send a one-time file thing. I think it would be useful to actually create a voicemail archive on your iCloud Drive and then save out voicemails that might have important information but you probably won't need, but you just want to archive just in case. That's a good way. Also, messages, mail, they're good ways to maybe forward messages on to people if you want them to be able to handle it or get that information. So that's kind of handy. It's all kind of handy function there. And also, the transcript allows you to tap and then copy. And then you can copy it and paste it into something else, or you can hit the share button there and then actually share the text. So if Apple's done a really good job with the transcription and you've got the directions someplace in there or information or phone number or name or whatever, you can just copy and send it somewhere and kind of get out of using an audio file to save that information.